Alright, what is up guys? Welcome to the video. It is Super Bowl Sunday. We have a long run this morning. It's about 9 a.m. right now and it's freezing cold right now. It's like 28 degrees. So I'm trying to hurry up and get started running, but again, long run this morning and let's get into it. I was made in gold, fall asleep, it's on my resume. Feeling low, pop the ceiling, please don't hesitate. Peeling off, chasing rats, keep me in shape. I don't wanna run my mind around every day. Okay, so we have the new trail shoes out today. Hopefully we can get them broke in before Lake Martin 100 without any issues like blisters and stuff. I think we can do that. We have like 40 days to do that, but yeah, we're at Wade Mountain. Hopefully gonna get 20, maybe a little more than 20 miles today. Let's get into it. Any night, any way, I'ma ride for you, love. Dollar signs, pockets swole, like it's swine. Many fold, many try, many go. I survived episodes I shouldn't have. Sell me some love drugs, I can make an album out of. So one thing I've been using some days during my long runs are these trekking poles. I don't know if I'm going to use them during Lake Martin, but we're going to practice with them just in case we do decide to use them. They really help with climbing. They help make it more of a full body movement instead of just using your legs. So you can use your arms to help you climb. Also, they can help with downhills to keep you from falling on your face. I'm still falling on my face here at Wade Mountain. But yeah, we're practicing with these. I don't know if we're going to use them or not, but yeah. Feet up, targeting me like a problem. Be a sovereign, what you want, I got em. And in my hindsight, all of this becoming silly. If I made a milli, then my mommy made a milli. Clearly on my next step, took me 4 hours. Why you can be my guest. Okay, so trekking poles don't always keep you from eating shit, because I just ate shit really bad. Probably the hardest fall I've ever taken. That sucked. But we are, where are we at in this run? 1 second, I don't know. We're 11 miles into this run. 9 more after I get up. Hard to catch sunshine waiting by my desk. You want fun times, I need nothing less. I don't wanna wait too long, do I have to? A lot of racing thoughts in my head. Mess around and play your parts, so you better. One shot like I never missed. Okay, so we just wrapped up that 20 mile long run and we had 2,600 feet of elevation gain and loss. And honestly, that run kicked my ass. Not so much the distance, but just literally falling on my face again and again and again, and a couple like hard falls, which, oh my god, that sucked. Luckily Lake Martin isn't very technical compared to this. There's just a bunch of roots and rocks hidden in the leaves and they'll get your ass. But that's gonna wrap up an 80 mile week for us this week, and tomorrow start all over. So I think I'm gonna go and get some food and then get home, shower, hopefully in time to see the beginning of the Super Bowl. So okay, so we made it home and we're pretty much relaxing, took a nap and also edited a video that can go out tomorrow on Monday, and we're watching the Super Bowl right here, hopefully pulling for a Bengals win. I really like Joe Burrow. All right, so we're gonna be wrapping up this video with all the gear I'm gonna be using for the Lake Martin 100 to hopefully get me to the finish line. No amount of gear is gonna get me to the finish line. It's gonna be all the training leading up to the 100 miler, but being prepared and having the things you need is definitely a plus and could probably definitely affect your race if you did not have them. So let's just start off with the most basic stuff, clothing. I'm a pretty minimalistic runner. If I'm not running like an ultra marathon, I usually just have shorts, shirt, if even a shirt, a hat, my watch, and some shoes on. But during an ultra marathon, aid stations are farther out apart than other races. So it's good to be able to carry more gear with you, so you know you'll have enough like nutrition or other things you might need during that longer stretch from aid station to aid station. But with that being said, let's just jump into, again, the most basic of the basic stuff, clothing. Starting off with these Nike Challenger shorts, really basic stuff. I like that these have pockets, even though I may not need them, but it's better to have pockets than not to have pockets. I can throw some extra goos in here if I need to, if my vest right here, we'll get into that in a second, if it's too full or whatever, I can throw some stuff in my pockets. Then we're gonna get into this Nike Rise 365 running t-shirt. It's nice and light. I recently just bought this and I really like it. Really not a lot to say about it, but it's dry fit, nice and light. I like it. I like running in this BPN hat. It's not structured, so you can just throw it in your bag or throw it in the washer and not have to worry about it losing its shape or anything. Also, I just like wearing a hat to keep my hair out of my face, also to help keep sweat out of my eyes and stuff. And I really like running in this hat. Then lastly, we're gonna get into this Salomon windbreaker. It's really just nice to have just an extra layer if I need it. Last year at the start of the Lake Martin 50, it was really, really cold. And then later on in the race, it got really, really hot. You know, just that Alabama weather, experiencing a lot of seasons in one day. And I will get into why I like this, just because of its packability. I can just throw this in my running vest. But I also found this for 60 bucks, it's normally $100. So I found it for 40% off. So I was like, yeah, I'm gonna snag that up. So that basically covers the clothing. Now let's get into the shoes. I, like you saw in the beginning of this video, I just purchased this pair of Nike Pegasus Trail 3s, Gore-Tex edition. It's a little more waterproof than just the normal ones. And this, what in this video, I did my first run in these shoes of 20 miles, and I really like these shoes. If you can't tell, I'm a big Nike guy. I don't know why, I just like the brands to like match, not to be clashing brands while you're wearing them. I don't know why, just grew up like that. But I do really like this. We're gonna have plenty of time to break these new shoes in before the race. But with it being 100 miles, I'm also gonna be bringing another pair of shoes just in case, you know, my feet don't like those shoes that day, I'm having trouble with blisters or just anything that happens, just having an extra pair of shoes. And these are the Nike Wild Horse 6s. I wore them in the 50 miles last year. And like trail shoes, what I've experienced, or at least with these shoes, is they're kind of tough to break in and be comfortable. But now that I've broken these in, like, I love these shoes. They're really comfortable. I started wearing them around the house or just running errands since I bought the new shoes, because usually I just like exclusively wear running shoes just to run in, just to help preserve as much life in them as I can. But since I got new trail shoes, I started wearing these more just out, and they're really, really comfortable. Now get into these Nike dry fit socks, just basic, your basic Nike dry fit socks. I've never really had trouble with blisters or anything like that since I started wearing like dry fit socks. Whenever I first started running 2 years ago, I just used any sock I found, and I found like the 100% cotton socks really tore at my feet. I really had trouble with blisters then, but these dry fit moisture wicking socks definitely helped me. Like, I haven't had blisters in years running in dry fit socks. And that's pretty much gonna wrap up the shoes and socks. Now let's get into the running vest. I bought this Salomon Advanced Skin 5 set running vest, and I really, really like it, and I'm questioning why I didn't buy a running vest sooner. Like, I would have loved to have this last year during the 50, but I didn't. This has two 17 ounce Salomon soft flasks. And that's plenty of water to get me from aid station to aid station. The longest trek from aid station to aid station I'm gonna have during Lake Martin is 8 miles, and this is gonna be plenty of water to carry with me. And like I was mentioning, how I like the Salomon windbreaker. It's just so easy, so compactable. I can just throw it in my vest without any trouble. I can start off with the windbreaker on. If I get too hot in that, take it off, put it in here. This has a nice zipper component that I can put my phone in. Just stuff that I know for sure I don't want to be falling out of this vest, so I can just zip it up. Also has just tons of room for everything I need. I can put gels in here. I don't have any gels on me to show you guys. Also, I'm gonna be carrying this GoPro Hero 9 Black with this shorty tripod slash selfie stick that's gonna help me document this race. And it's gonna be easy peasy, just throwing it in my running vest, nice and comfortable. Dude, I really wish I would have bought one of these sooner. Okay, so I've done this clip a few times, and each time I forget a really important piece of gear. And this past time I did it, I forgot my headlamp. And we're gonna be running at night during this 100-mile race, and a headlamp is crucial for our success in this race. So this is my headlamp. It is the Petzl Actic. It is a headlamp with 350 lumens. It is powered by 3 AAA batteries, but it does have the option of, you can buy like a rechargeable battery for this headlamp. But for me, I would rather just have AAA batteries, so I can just carry batteries with me instead of having to charge another battery and make sure it's charged. So I'd rather just carry around more batteries than I need and not have to worry about it. But yeah, back to the rest of the gear. One of the last things we're gonna talk about is going to be my running watch I'm gonna be using during this race. This is the Kuros Vertex 1. It was $600, but they recently went on sale for $500 since Kuros came out with the Vertex 2. And you can buy fitness watches for a lot of different reasons. A lot of watches do a lot of different things, like Apple Watches can do a lot of things that this watch can't. Garmin has their Fenix series that can do a lot of things that this can't. But my main focus with a running watch is just basically two things. It's accuracy, GPS accuracy, tracking my distance and my pace, and battery life. And what Kuros does, the small simple things it does really well. It's really hard to find a watch with the battery life that this has. This has 60 hours of full GPS mode and over 100 hours in Ultramax mode, and I love it. I love how I can wear this watch for weeks without having to charge it, and so I'm not connected to a charger all the time. I can sleep in this watch, I can track my sleep in this watch, and during the 100-mile race, thinking about my battery life is not even gonna cross my mind. So I really like my Kuros Vertex watch. And the last item on the agenda is going to be the thing I showed you earlier in this video. It's gonna be the Black Diamond Trail Sport 2 trekking poles. Now, I don't know if I'm going to use these during the race or not, but I'm practicing with them just in case I do decide to. I bought these inexpensive pair of trekking poles for around 50 bucks, and they have trekking poles that are like $200+, and I was like, I don't even know if I'm gonna use these. I'm not gonna pay $200 for trekking poles if I don't know if I'm gonna use them or not. But I have enjoyed using these, and you know, I don't know if I'm going to use them or not during the race, but I mean, we'll find out whenever the race day comes. But that's pretty much gonna wrap up all of the gear I'm gonna be using for this race. Hopefully this did not bore you as much as I think it did, but again, I'm gonna have everything linked below in the description of this video if you see anything you like and you may want to check it out to see if you want to get it for yourself. But yeah, that is all the gear I'm going to be using. So that's pretty much going to wrap up the video. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in the next one.
anyway. I'ma ride for you, love. Dollar signs, pockets swole, like it's swine. Many fold, many try, many go.